yuck. Look at that. It's just crusted with aphids. It's disgusting. I'm just gonna pull this out. And I need to harvest the sweet potatoes. I've been kind of putting it off a little bit because I was hoping to allow the sweet potatoes to grow a little longer since we've been having a little bit of heat. But they're starting to yellow, so I guess it's time. And like I said, I'm just gonna pull up the kale because this is just really nasty. All this is just aphids. I saw in Curtis Stone, what is it called? Urban Farmer, Curtis Stone Urban Farmer. He pulls his leaves off in the fall, and then he sprays all the leaves. I mean, not the leaves, the stems, to kill the aphids. But I don't know if I want to be bothered with all that. I have a lot of kale plants, and these just look like they're really suffering. So I'm just gonna cut them back. Pull them up, cut them back, whatever is needed. And I don't know. We'll see what happens. I'm just gonna play it by ear. Small. It's like a beet, but it's not. It's a sweet potato. This here is, these two came out of, these came from, this ornamental, yikes. This ornamental sweet potato, purple, and it had these white roots, which is kind of curious to me. Anyway, so this is the carnage of what used to be my barrels. Well, that's the carnage, and this is the remnants, I guess. Not sure what I'm gonna do with these kales. I'm thinking what I want to do though is just replant them, cut off the tops or something, or at least take off all the diseased. Well, it's not diseased. They're just full of aphids. And I think I'm just gonna take the leaves off and just allow them to grow. Yeah, see, this is a good one. Allow them to grow back. It's supposed to be. I went to church on Sunday and we're already talking about Thanksgiving, so I volunteered to make the kale, so maybe if this stuff grows back, I can have kale for Thanksgiving. I don't know. We'll see how it goes. They're being shy, and they just ate, so I know that they're kind of noticing me watching them, so. But before the end of the day, that pile is probably going to be just sticks and stems. Here's a better look at today's harvest. It's that beet-sized, beet-shaped. So this is the variety that I grew last year. I didn't expect them to get very big, but I have to say I'm a little bit disappointed because they're not as big as they were last year. I grew them in that container, in those, those two barrels. This is what came out of two barrels, so not a very good harvest. This is the, this is what I harvested a couple of weeks ago. So in comparison, yeah, look at that. It's like the same silly carrot-shaped, carrot-sized harvest. So anyway, I still have some sweet potatoes to collect from the other community garden at 4th Street, and I hope to do that tomorrow. I really, 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 really want to get that done as soon as possible because, you know, the days are really nice. And I really don't want to be out there, like, harvesting stuff when it's, like, cold and, you know, the weather's threatening to have frost. So, anyway, like I said, I really, 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 really want to do that. But, you know, I try to limit myself to one hard task per day because I just really don't have the stamina for all that effort, so maybe I'll do that tomorrow. But in the meantime, I'm gonna try and take these sweet potatoes upstairs, and yeah, I'll probably just do the same with this, just stick this in a paper bag and take it upstairs and be done with it. There they are. Well, the second shelf in here, it's nice and sturdy. At least I hope it holds things well. I kind of meant to put some cross braces on there, but I totally forgot about that. Maybe I'll do that later. In the meantime, I'm boiling up in this greenhouse. It's really hot in there. And, yuck. Oh, what a difference that makes. Anyway, going inside now. Thanks for watching.